Everybody, Wingapo. It is me, Raid Rachel, my unpaid, unofficial, self-led, non-internship for Twitch. So thanks for tuning in. We're gonna play a little Valangi today, do a little air guitar. I'm gonna try not to mess up my hair this Thursday. Because I did it again. I did the hydrating shampoo with conditioner with hair gel for Jura's Day. This double shot of love tonight. So I'm excited about that. And I did Nikki Hall makeup. I talked about that on social media. Because she does a no makeup look. I mean, she says she's not wearing makeup, but she's so obviously wearing makeup. And she does her no makeup look. Like, when you're not wearing makeup, like, your skin tone is naturally different colors. Like, there's a little red here, a little orange here, a little purple here. And her face is, like, all one color. So she's obviously putting on a lot of foundation, a lot of powder, probably some eyeshadow that matches her her skin tone. She says that she's just wearing chapstick, like, totally not true. So I did Nikki Hall-inspired makeup look by putting on foundation. I didn't put powder on, so it would look a little bit more dewy. And then I put on this nude eyeshadow. I put on some mascara because she's wearing false lashes. And I really like my eyebrows today. What I did was, I don't know which side it's on because I don't know if this is like a mirror or not. But I filled in like a gap with a pencil and put powder on it, and that was it. Because one of my friends is telling me, like, you should really wear your eyebrows like lighter. And I was like, I don't know how to do that. Because there are so many gaps, and I'm like, how am I going to fill it all in? Natural gaps. Like, how am I going to fill it all in and, like, have it look light, you know? I realized I could just fill in that one gap and put in some powder, and it looks pretty light. Put in a light brown. So hopefully if they see this, they like it, and this lip color kind of matches my lip. I talk about it all the time. It's called Camelot. And I put on kind of like a duty pink blush. That's kind of like skin color more than like bright pink, rosy glow. It's just kind of like, you know, like to kind of look like a little bit more no makeup look. So that's that. I have a teeny little spiel that I want to do on camera before I open the longing. It's about the whole, like, clinically tired thing, because my friend was telling me that it might not just be, like, family problems that you had, or which resolved, and also, what was the other one? Oh, like, empathizing with new parents, and cell phone use at night, and stuff, and, like, bullying, and, like, no one sleeps anymore, except for you. And they said it could be like, okay, everyone like naturally has a face, and what happens is like people just constantly inadvertently or advertently bully it, kind of. Let's say I used to have a unibrow and I plucked it out. People who know you will always make you go like this. To make it look like you have a unibrow again or something. Or like if people think your face is really small like mine, like they're going to try to puff out your cheeks to make it look bigger. Like it could be inadvertent, it could be intentional, it could be unintentional, it could be inadvertent. But people just aren't cool. Like they just constantly like can't accept your face for exactly what it looks like. With me, he's saying, people always want to make this part lower. Which is weird, because if you know me, you know, this is a real picture from my childhood. Look how low my face is. My face has always been this low. So, like, people just keep trying to make it lower, and I'm like, this is as low as it goes. This is my freaking face. And it's funny because he says it's my face backwards. Like when I was born, my face was, this was all the way up to here to my lower eyelashes. And my face was totally smooth. Like right now, I can get some wrinkles if I go like that, you know? Which I thought were from the sun. Apparently, you're born with them. They're just like, I call them King of the Hill lines. Because in King of the Hill, like in the animation, they do draw some like lines to like emphasize where like people's faces are like the character in people's faces, like the natural character. But they were saying like for 92% of my life, I've had a completely smooth face. So this is my backwards face because they were saying that the doctor bullied me when I came out of the, as soon as the doctor saw me, they started bullying my face. So I turned my face backwards. So like this is here and that is there. And like everything is backwards. That's what they're telling me. So I don't mind, but like apparently they were like, you wanted to go as low as it could possibly go, like while it's still like natural and healthy and you can feel all your feelings, because you never want to mess with somebody's face, because that's how they process heat, that's how they process cold, that's how they process light, that's how they process sadness and happiness and love and hopefully not anger. But if anger isn't like there, it's like it turns your face red or something. Like, this is my dog face. This is my dog body. This is just like how I look. So like he's telling me people keep trying to make this lower and lower, so that I don't look like a narcissist or something. This is just my natural body. Like I'm not, and you can tell narcissism from people's eyes when they get like really, like piercing. That's how I describe it. And then they put it somewhere else in their body and you can still kind of tell, but you can tell from my entire body, I'm clinically not a narcissist at all. And I just have no narcissistic feelings, intentions, thoughts, habits, patterns. So, I like that about myself because I'm like, I'm just going to have fun with my makeup. Like, I know I'm not a narcissist. Like, I like just having fun with my fashion. You know, I think fashion is art. I think the human body is art. You know, I just have fun. But people are like, oh, like, if you're, I don't know, like, if you're wearing lipstick on, and you're living at home, you're a narcissist. And I'm like, I just like wearing lipstick, you know? like, I don't know. So they're saying that, they actually did my, I'm, like, really sensitive, and I'm a healing machine. That's why this is my dog face, this is where I'm wearing dog body. I'm just, like, a healing machine. Like, they were saying that, like, a lot of people get really easily startled by, like, the wind, you know, and they can, like, and that's okay, like, they're not in a lot of pain if they get startled by the wind. Me, I just, bam, process the wind. Like, I don't, I would be in a lot of pain if I couldn't process the wind, you know? So they did move my face down a fraction of a millimeter, and that's why I'm so tired. Because, like, I mean, like, I'm not an addictive narcissist, so I shouldn't be susceptible to bullying at all. But I just, like, for some reason, he's saying I'm, like, such a good girl, like, spiritually. I'm like, if people want to move my face down, I will move it down. So I moved it down a fraction of a millimeter. And now my sleep is messed. And a bunch of other things, too, kind of. He says it makes me look like I have indigestion, but I don't have indigestion. He said, it kind of makes me, like, it's kind of painful for me to hold my head here. Like, this is less painful. That makes no sense. There is actually a saying, a lot of people, this is their most comfortable face, and it makes them look like non-narcissist, but my most comfortable face is actually up here. It's actually, like, chin up. God just made me that way. And when I look down, this usually comes up, but they're holding it down here. So, like, weird. They said it looks like I'm focusing on something far away and close up at the same time. And at first it was a joke, and now it's no longer a joke. So it's just disheartening, you know? So that's my spiel. Just stop facial abuse, you know? This is contrail now. Just like all this bullying. Now it's kind of here. This is my comfortable face. Now it's here. So annoying. And every once in a while, like, my face will come all the way back on, and it's so comfortable. Like, right now I'm in pain right here. Like, here, kind of. But they said it's not actually pain. Like, if you're not a vindictive narcissist, you're not in any pain. It's just healing discomfort. Like, I have to constantly heal there. Oh, let's see if it captured. Yes, it did. To make sure that you're not seeing a blank screen while I'm just playing a video game. It's not, like, you guys can't see it. so annoying when people ask what your video is. So annoying. But yeah, sometimes it is totally fine. And like, and then like, I'll like go to my car and then it's like, damn it. People try to do this a lot with me too to make it look like I'm angry. I don't know why. Because I'm like the least angry person who ever lived. But like I like going like that sometimes because it's easier to focus on the light. Like I'm looking at a bright light. Like it's easier and then it kind of comes back a little bit. I mean, the human body is so complicated. There are like a million reasons why you would furrow your eyebrows and none of them is anger. When I was a kid, someone told me to never. I had a beautiful forehead though, just never wrinkle it though. So. I don't like wrinkling mine. Makes me feel like more like myself to just be like who? It feels like Rachel Freeman to just be there. So. But maybe we'll feel more like Rachel Freeman to be here. But your face is connected with the rest of your body. You know, if you stub your toe and you make a face, that might be healing your stubbed toe. You know, so it's really important not to mess up people's faces. I think there's always a piece of gold here. I don't know, I just kind of have the suspicion that one day, God... It's not like I'm praying to God to, like, make my face more comfortable. but I have a feeling one day he will just do it, you know. And be like, enough is enough. You're still a good girl. You don't have to give in to the bullies to be a good girl, you know. And give the bullies what they want. My friends tell me that giving the bullies what they want makes them insane, though. So maybe it's like an unexoneration and just keep doing it. But I'm not doing that intentionally. I just relax my face and try to make it. That's the name of my game. They said actually, if you're a non-vindictive narcissist, you don't age, and if you do anything. That like looks like aging or something, it ages backwards at 30. So I'm down to my baby legs actually. It's very important to not bully anybody. If they go someplace new too. Is there any place you want to revisit? Like, I kind of want to revisit that water place. Not from yesterday. I was a little worried about that actually from yesterday. You should check this out. But I also want to visit that water place. Oh! I tried this book in. Make sure this isn't a problem. Because I was like, is the whole cave going to go away? So today I was going to talk about happier stuff, that we've gone over facial abuse.